Ronaldo, Kaká, Vieira, Lampard. That's just the start of it. The team is insane.
This might be the most insane attack. Thierry Henry, Messi, in the midfield, Xavi. I mean, guys, I honestly can't comprehend this.
Pep Guardiola and Jose Mourinho, two of arguably the best managers of all time in the game of football. Starting with Pep Guardiola, this dude has managed clubs such as Barcelona, Bayern Munich, and, well, we all know he's at City now. He's won La Liga, the Bundesliga, the Champions League, the Copa del Rey, the Premier League, the UEFA Super Cup, the German Super Cup, the Spanish Super Cup, the FIFA Club World Cup. Guys, what hasn't this dude won? And as for Jose Mourinho, he's one of only just five managers in the history of the game to win two Champions League titles with two different teams. He won it with Porto in 2004 and Inter Milan back in 2010.
But yeah, other than that, I mean, he's won so many titles, man, with Porto, Chelsea, Inter, Real Madrid, so many cups. They're both just absolute legends.
So what we've done today is comprised two teams, one of Jose Mourinho's All-Stars and another of Pep Guardiola's All-Stars.
So we have done it like this. Mourinho's All-Stars are going to be on Real Madrid, and then Guardiola's All-Stars are going to be on Barcelona.
And what I'm most excited for today is we have icons. So I haven't been able to include every icon, but the majority of them are going to be in this. Let me know if ones were missed. If they were missed, it's just because they weren't in the game or they weren't in this specific mod.
We are on the PC version, so that is how we were able to get these icons. So let's get into it, boys, without further ado, by showing you the teams. First, let's start out with Real Madrid. This is Jose Mourinho's All-Stars. You guys need to let me know which team is better down below in the comments. 3, 2, 1. Here it is, in its beauty, in its glory. Up front, Cristiano Ronaldo, Zlatan Ibrahimovic, 91 rated, Figo. And then, oh boy, man, look at this midfield. Could it get any better? We have Kaká, 92 rated. Vieira, 91 rated. And Lampard, 90 rated.
Defense, Marcelo, Sergio Ramos, John Terry, Zanetti, and then Iker Casillas in goal. I don't know why, but he's one of the most icons that's most exciting to me today, just because his stats have been buffed up. So you're going to see a lot of these players who are still in FIFA, but are out of their prime and have lower rated, I was going to say cards, but just are lower rated now in FIFA 19. Their ratings have been buffed up. So Zlatan is one of those. Casillas is one of those. We have Torres on the bench. He is one of those. Speaking of the bench, Hazard, Salah are just a few. If you guys don't remember, Salah ended up playing with Mourinho at Chelsea for a brief period. And then here is the bench, guys. This is one. I just added him because I completely forgot he was on the team. Makelele, I believe he played for Mourinho in Chelsea back in like 2004-ish. He could literally make the starting 11. But I think I'm going to put on the bench for Casemiro. Guys, this team is absolutely unreal. We have Cole as well in here. Mesut Ozil, Drogba as well. I completely forgot about Drogba. Pogba's here. We got Drogba, we got Pogba. Who don't we have on this team?
So unfortunately, not all of the icons were available. Let me know which ones that were missed. Again, if they were missed, not my fault. It's just because they literally weren't in the game. I literally went through and compiled all of them, put them on their respective teams. This is the squad, and it's absolutely incredible. Let me know if you would change anything from this in the starting 11 or subs or bench. I think I'm just going to keep the bench as is. I might take out Aspie and put in like Ashley Cole or something like that, just so we can get a few more icons into the team. I would love to fit Drogba in, maybe for Torres. I think we're just gonna keep it as is though for now.
Next up, Barcelona, Guardiola's All-Stars. Now Guardiola hasn't managed for as long as Mourinho has, I don't think. At least from like all the research I did, I don't think he has, but he still has a great set of players. Here is the Barcelona team. Guardiola's All-Stars right here up front. Alexis Sanchez, Thierry Henry at striker, Lionel Messi at the right wing in the defense, Xavi, Iniesta, and a Bastian Swine striker. Now here is the thing. A lot of these players have played for both managers. So I tried to even it out. I think Schweinsteiger was one of those who has played for both managers, because Schweinsteiger played for Mourinho at Manchester United, I believe. So I tried to even it out and put those players who have played for both on the team.
that has made the most sense. So let me know if I got any of those wrong. In the defense, Alaba at the left back, Carlos Puyol center back, PK, Philipp Lahm, love to see him in there, and then Manuel Neuer in net. Moving on to the bench, Lewandowski, Aguero, you're going to see a lot of the Manchester City players in here simply because he still manages at Manchester City right now. David Villa is another one in the squad. Vidal. I think Vidal played under Guardiola. If he didn't, let me know. That one might be wrong, but I think he did. We got Eto, another one of those who has played for both managers, but I decided to put him on this team. I think Xabi Alonso played for both managers as well, but I put him on this team. Yaya Toure played for Guardiola, I think back at Barca. And you guys can just see the rest of the list. Now, this team, I want to say, has a few less icons than the Real Madrid or Mourinho All-Star team. And I want to say, I don't know, the teams are pretty even for the most part. Let me know what you think, though. Which team has the upper hand? As always, vote in the top right-hand corner. Which team you think is going to win today's All-Star Challenge? And now that you've seen the teams, I don't think I missed anything. No, I don't think we did. Yeah, let's get into it, boys. So if you don't know how this works, how we do these All-Star Challenges is we take both teams. There's going to be two legs. The first leg is a head-to-head matchup. Whichever team comes out on top wins leg one. Leg two is a career mode simulation where both teams are put into the career mode and into the Champions League. Whichever team comes out higher in the Champions League is going to be the winner. If it comes down where it needs to be a tiebreaker, whichever team has the top goal scorer or higher ranked goal scorer in the Champions League, that's the tiebreaker. That's how we determine a winner. So first off, let's get in to the head-to-head matchup. As you saw, the ratings were pretty much the same. Real Madrid just has a little bit more of an advantage in the defensive category, but other than that, literally you cannot get more even than this. Teams are set, lineups are set, let's get into this. So here it is, let's go, boys. Let's see who is going to get the win here. As you can see, Kaká right there. That is, I don't believe that's his player face. So some of the icons don't have the actual player faces because they're not in the game. I think only the icons that are in Ultimate Team have the correct player faces and everything. I just got this mod from a FIFA mod website. So if you guys want to download this for yourself, you have the PC version. I will leave that linked in the description for you guys to download. Try these icons for yourself. Let's get in them, though, and see who wins leg one. Is it going to be Mourinho or Guardiola? Mourinho's All-Stars, and it's Figo down the wing, setting it across to Cristiano Ronaldo. It's going to be a goal. It's already 1-0 to Mourinho. Cristiano Ronaldo, what do you expect, man? Not really great defending at all right there for the Guardiola All-Stars, but it's going to be 1-0 regardless. Real Madrid again. Vieira with the shot, and what a save from the Barca keeper. It's Manuel Neuer, man, keeping them in this. Could have been 2-0 right here. Real Madrid or Mourinho's squad. Zlatan with the shot. Another player that I believe could have fit on both teams, but we ended up putting him on Mourinho's team right there. Yeah, misses that opportunity. Here comes Barca now in Zanetti. No, not Zanetti. Zanetti guarding Sanchez in the punch out from Casillas. Look at this. Through ball played in. Iniesta makes it 1-1. Game on, boys. The equalizer of dreams from an absolute Barcelona legend in Team Guardiola. The Guardiola All-Stars are back in this. Zlatan on it. Lays it off to Lampard. Oh my God. Should have been a goal right there. Wow. Into the second half we go. And it's a great save to start things off. Guardiola All-Stars right here. Barcelona nearly taking the lead in the second half. What a save, though, from Casillas again. Barca right here. Thierry Henry got a touch to it, I think. It was Iniesta with a shot, though. Wow. Oh, my God. It's Messi. Messi is through. He hits it off the post. You're kidding me. And the rebound goes out of play. That was Guardiola's chance to go ahead, and Messi couldn't do it for him. Uh-oh. 66th minute. Right here is Figo. You can see him very easily with those green shoes. And it's Ronaldo again. Literally the same goal that they scored in the first half. Figo to Ronaldo. And the volley or the cross right there, it gets completed. Ball goes in. 2-1. Mourinho back on top. A minute of added time left to go. And it's looking like this is going to belong. Yep, that's going to seal the deal. A goal making it 3-1 in favor of Mourinho. And of course, Real Madrid, and it slots on Ibrahimovic. He puts it in, the dagger. Again, another player that could have been on either team decided to give him or put him on the team with Mourinho. And, well, he doesn't disappoint right there. Scoring it, 3-1, game over. So with this victory, Mourinho wins leg number one. It's time to get into leg number two, though, where we shall see what happens. Can Guardiola equalize? Let's find out. Let's get into it. So I just want to clear this up before we get into the career mode simulation. Every other team has icons as well. So it's not just our two teams. You're going to see here United with Schmeichel, with Best, Van de Sar on the bench. They got Wayne Rooney pretty much in his prime right here. Keane, Giggs, Ferdinand. I mean, most every other team is going to have icons as well. So it's not going to be a walk in the park for either of our two all-star teams. We're going to find out what happens, though. So as always, we are going to get into this with a neutral team, and we're just going to do it in La Liga, and we're going to use Atletico Madrid. So let's get into it, boys. Our two icon teams going up against each other. We got to make sure they're both in the Champions League, though, which they should. Yeah, they are. I mean, Barca and Real, perfect, man. Both teams our their current squads. We got to do it. Next time we see you guys, season will be simmed and we'll have a winner. Here we go. And here we are, end of the season. And if this gives you any indication as to how the Champions League is going to go, look how close La Liga was. La Liga means nothing, but 2 points separated both teams. Let's jump into the Champions League and let's find out ourselves a winner of today's video. So I'm going to assume both of our teams made it out. Barca right there, Guardiola's team topping the group. Madrid, though. There they are, topping the group as well. Madrid, right there. That is Mourinho's squad. Let's get into it, boys. Both teams doing well. Now it's time to just go round by round and see which teams made it, which teams didn't. Oh my god, Real Madrid barely beating Inter. Inter is a team with a lot of other icons as well. So, yeah, and that one's funny as well because Mourinho also managed Inter, and he beat another club that he managed. As for Barca, they beat Galatasaray 2-0. All right, both teams on to the quarterfinals. Here we go. And Barca just squeaking by Juventus. And Real Madrid just squeaking by Hoffenheim. Both teams on to the semis. Could you imagine they both match up against each other in the final? Let's find out, boys. Oh, my God. They matched up against each other in the semis. And it's Real Madrid. And it's Mourinho who won both head-to-head matchups in today's All-Star Challenge. I don't know if this has happened before. Have both teams come up against each other in the Champions League before in these videos that we've done in the past? No clue. And there it is. Real Madrid win the Champions League as well. That is crazy. This was an insane episode. Let me know if you guys want to see more of these challenges with icons, and let me know down below in the comment section which one of these videos should we do next. In La Liga, this is crazy. Eden Hazard, 30 goals for Real Madrid. Whoa. In the Champions League, it was Best, and then it was Hazard. We have Thierry Henry in there as well. We have Lampard. I want to say that Real Madrid's team was just a little too overpowered. I think they had a few more better overall players, which is why they won today's video. Guys, that is going to be it for today's episode. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Let me know which one of these All-Star Challenge videos we should do next. Really enjoyed making this one, and we'll see you guys for another episode later on. Catch you guys then. Peace. Reach for the stars, 'cause we're aiming high.